Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making oven-baked Parmesan potatoes, and everyone loves potatoes, and this has a little different twist to it, so I thought you might enjoy it. We're starting out with our potatoes. You notice here I have a pack of three Idaho potatoes. That means they're good for baking. They are russet variety, but you don't have to have that particular kind. This, I think, is 26 ounces, so it's over 2 pounds. So somewhere between 2 and 3 pounds worth of potatoes. If you'll just peel those and then cut them in chunks, and those should be fairly large chunks like this. And then drain them, and then have a bowl ready. And I've got some water in the bottom there. I'm gonna put that in the sink. And I'm going to pour these chunks of potatoes into this bowl so that I can use the bowl for mixing. So we have our cubed up potatoes, raw. You're going to add in 1/2 cup of chopped green pepper. And this is the other part of it. Actually, the 1/2 cup corresponded to 1/2 of a green bell pepper. So there's the other half we don't need for this dish, so I'll use it for something later. But I'm just adding in 1/2 cup chopped green bell pepper. And then we have onion. This is just an example onion. I did use the yellow onion. You can use white if you prefer. And I need 1/3 cup finely chopped onion. And I happen to have some in the refrigerator that I had chopped just a couple days ago. And I cook so much that I have needs for things like that, and I save them, so I didn't have to do it again. I have 1/3 cup of chopped onion going right in there in the mix. The next thing I have is some melted butter, and you'll see right here it is. It's cooled off a little bit. It's like at room temperature. Doesn't really matter, but I wouldn't put it in too hot. This is 1/4 cup or 1/2 stick of butter melted. Just put that around there. And then we have some really nice flavorful cheese. This is Parmesan cheese, and I'm using the finely shredded variety. You can use, you can get a block and shred it yourself. You can grate it. It might be finer than this. This will be about 1 cup's worth if you want the shredded. And then a few spices before we stir that up. I'm going to use seasoned salt, and I will need 1/2 teaspoon. So there it is. I'm going to use seasoned pepper. Now, if you're not familiar with that or you can't find it, just use freshly ground black pepper. Or if you can't find that, just shake in some regular ground black pepper. You need 1/2 teaspoon. So I have 1/2 teaspoon of the seasoned pepper. That's going to make it taste really good. And then one more spice, and this is garlic powder. And I need just 1/4 teaspoon of the garlic powder. And that's pretty much it. So what I'm going to do is combine all of this. And you see, it's going to be really a pretty dish because we're going to bake it in the oven. And that cheese will melt, and the specks of green in there will look really appetizing. So when you get it mixed together, and make sure all of those herbs are and spices are dispersed so that they are fairly even in coverage. When you get all of that mixed together, then have a dish ready that has been sprayed with cooking oil spray, and then just put your casserole in there, and what we're going to have are some luscious potatoes from this. These are oven-baked Parmesan potatoes, but they have herbs and spices too, so don't forget, they're going to have a little bit of zing to them as well. So I'm going to just spread this out a little bit. Now, if I had a lid for this casserole, I would use the lid. I needed sort of the size of casserole, and I didn't have a lid. What you can do in that case is just take an appropriate piece of aluminum foil, and you'll want to cover it completely. and then put this in a 350 degree oven, and I'll watch it so that maybe after 15 minutes I'll take a fork and see if they're getting tender. Probably won't be. I'm expecting 20 minutes to a half hour, something like that, but I'll keep track of the time. So here it goes, and I'll let you see it when it comes out of the oven. Here are our oven-baked Parmesan potatoes, and I'll tell you how I baked them. I left them under the foil for 40 minutes. Then I took the foil off and baked them for 10 minutes longer, so that's a total of 50 minutes. After that, to crisp them off on the top a little bit, I let them, I turned them to broil, and I let them stay about 3 minutes broiling under the broiler. So I want to show you that they're nice and tender, just like a baked potato you would expect, nice and crumbly. And when you spoon some out into a dish, here's what you get. You get a nice serving that has all of that cheese flavor, and the whole kitchen has just got this aroma of the spices that went in here. And you can see there's a little bit of browned up edge that looks really nice. It's a great dish.